Hello friends and welcome to this new tutorial on ansys. My name is Keyur. I am M.Tech machine design student from IIT Bombay. In this series of tutorial I will explore you to the ansys software from basics to the advanced. Now I will try to make these videos as much interesting as possible and make sure that you will learn this software on a completely different level than what you have expected. Okay, so let us discuss the goals of this lecture. First one is, what is ansys? And along with this I will also explain you the difference between a simulation and an animation. The second one is, why you should learn ansys. The third one is the prerequisites of ansys. The fourth one is how to download a free student version of ansys from ansys website. And the last point that we are going to discuss is that what will be there in the next lecture. Now let's get to our first question, which is, what is ansys? Now let me give you an example. Let us consider manufacturing of a car. Now before you launch a car into the market, it first needs to be tested under various test conditions like endurance test, crash test, etc. This is something which you all know. Also you need to optimize the material, which means that you need to use as much minimum material as possible to make your car a lightweight and also to reduce the cost of manufacturing a car by reducing the material. Also you need to check the thermal analysis of your engine. Now if we intend to do all this analysis conventionally without using a software, we have to do all these experiments repeatedly until we get the perfect design to suit our requirements. Doing this many repeated tests practically before manufacturing the car is very costly and also too much time consuming. So what actually the car manufacturer does is that they simulate all the above steps in a finite element analysis software like ansys or abacus. Now I will explain later that what is finite element analysis, but for now let me explain what is simulation. We will again take the same example of a car. So this time, instead of testing it manually, we will first prepare a CAD model in any of the software like Creo, SolidWorks, CATIA, etc. So here I am assuming that you know how to prepare a CAD model and what is a CAD software. These are all the informations you know that I am assuming. So as you can see, I have made a CAD model of a car impact with a rigid wall. Although I have made this simulation just for the presentation purpose, so there is not much detailing. But you can understand clearly that if I make a proper car model with all the detailing and then carry out the simulation, then the results that I will get from the impact simulation will be similar to the results from the actual impact test. And thus we can redesign the car based on the simulation results. And then when the final design is done, at that time only we will carry out actual impact experiments. This will save a significant amount of time and money. Now don't worry about the present example. I will make a separate detailed video on how to carry out impact simulation of a car and try to explain it in very simple and interesting manner so that many of you can understand it very easily. So as I told you that I will explain you the difference between a simulation and an animation. Now don't mistake a simulation by an animation. An animation is some imaginary phenomena placed together in the form of frames, and with the computer graphics, smooth motion of object is created. Now let's say that you draw 10 pictures on 10 different papers and you run all these 10 pictures at high frames to form a video. This is what an animation is. For example, all the cartoons, animation, games. The more basic example is to draw a picture on each page of a book and then turn the pages quickly to form an animation. This is something which you have all seen. Now let me show you a live example. As you can see, a picture is drawn on each of the pages, and as you turn the pages quickly, you can visualize it as a short clip now. So anyway, it is an example of a low level animation, and now this is what an animation is. Then what is a simulation? A simulation is also a kind of animation, but it is governed by the laws of physics, which means unlike your video games or cartoons or movies, or unlike the clip that I have already shown you before, in simulation, whatever you will see in the software will be almost the same that would have occurred in the practical situations also. Now let me give you a live example of simulation. Now as I told you, I will explain you what simulation is. So here's the example. I have made a CAD model of a beam and I have fixed it on this particular end and I have applied a 50,000 Newton load on this end and there is a hole at the center. So basically it is a simple cantilever beam with hole at the center. Now I have calculated four different results. Equivalent stress, which is equivalent 1 minus stress, equivalent strain, directional deformation in y direction, and plastic deformation. Now our component does not undergo any plastic deformation, so ansys is not showing any results. Now I will explain you later what all these results mean, but currently I will focus only on showing you what is simulation. So let's check out the first results. which is equivalent 1 minus stress. Now let me run the simulation. So as you can see that when the load is about to act, the beam is completely blue and you can see the stress generating in the beam as the load acts. One more thing that you can note is that there is more stress near the hole due to stress concentration. Now if you have made the beam model of same dimension with hole at the center, the 1 minus stress generated will be nearly the same as what we have seen here. So as I told you, a simulation is a type of animation only, but whatever happens in it is linked to physics and not just imaginary stuff. One more thing that I want to tell you here is that let's say that your material's yield strength is 250 MPa. So it will fail when normal stress of about 250 MPa is generated. So you can redesign the beam maybe by increasing the dimension or reducing the load, and you can again analyze it once its stress value is less than 250 MPa. Then only you can prepare a physical real life model of a beam and test it. So in this way you can save significant amount of time, money and resources, and this is the reason why people use software in modern engineering. Now we come to our most important question, which is why should I learn ansys? So the most basic answer is that you can simulate real life problems without spending much money on the practical, but this will not be enough motivation for you to be a CAE engineer. So instead, I personally suggest you that you go to Google and search future of CAE engineers, and then you can decide by yourself from the results that you get from the Google that you should learn this software or not. Not only this, in 2015 NAFEMS was held. Technically speaking, it is a huge summit for CAE specialists. In this summit, Danish Nagy, who is the principal of Beyond CAE, told that we need a design centric workflow instead of simulation centric. Now for design centric, what he wants to say is that if you want to design a pump, then learn the software for designing pump only. The reason behind him saying this is because ansys and abacus are very versatile software and can be used in variety of application. Now what is a simulation centric? Simulation centric is that you learn a simulation software and then use it according to your skill in all the relevant areas that you can use your knowledge. But contradictory, what I think is that imagine that if you learn a software, then how much versatile you can be and in how many different industries you can get a job. Imagine the variety of jobs you get, from vibration control to determining safety, from noise control to optimizing the design, from piping design to aero modeling, and most important of all is coordinating design and manufacturing to acquire new production capabilities. Example, additive manufacturing, which is also considered as the future of manufacturing, and an extensive research is going on in this field. Not only this, you can yourself apply your knowledge and find a new application. Now my second answer for this question is that it can be very useful to college students to carry out various projects, as there can be tons of projects that can be performed in ansys software, and you can pass out from the college with some amazing skills as mechanical, civil, aerospace or automobile engineers. The third point, the third answer to this question is that if you want to have a product based startup, you can easily create, analyze and validate your product by yourself. So let's say that you have a crazy idea in your mind, then you can try it by yourself. Let's say that if you have a product in your mind, then you can prepare a CAD model of it, you can analyze it, and then you can launch it into the market. If you can interpret from your analysis that your product is capable enough of fulfilling some specific requirements which it is designed for. Now our next question is, what are the prerequisites of ansys? So you need to have a sound knowledge in your basic subjects like strength of material, mechanics, finite element methods, fluid mechanics and engineering materials. Now it's not like that you need to be the master of all those subjects, just the basic knowledge in these subjects initially will do it for you, and you will automatically start getting it with use. See, the idea is ansys will provide you many answers, but how you interpret those answers will depend on your knowledge. If you knew basic structure, materials and theory, then you can easily model problems. So if you are going to take ansys, you should have knowledge in your basic subjects. Without understanding what is fatigue, what is stress, what is strain, what is directional deformation, it will be difficult for you to interpret the results that you get through ansys. Now I will show you how to download free student version of ansys from ansys website. So go to Google and type free ansys student version download and select the first option in the Google search. This will lead you to the ansys site, there select ansys student option and click here. There are installation steps also provided, we just have to follow these steps. So first, download it. Remember, our license is only valid till April 30, 2019, which is about 1 year from its release date. So after that, you have to download it again. But it is very simple to download it. So it won't be any problem as we are getting the software for free and that also for 1 year. Now you have to check the system requirements to install this ansys software. Also, it is a student version, so there is a fixed size of problem till which you can perform the analysis, after which either ansys will crash out or it may not perform the analysis at all. But the limit is too large for academic purposes for student to work with, so don't have to bother about it. Okay, then let's download it by pressing agree and download. So it will download the zip file. So once it is downloaded, extract file from your zip file to any location in your PC. Like I have extracted in ansys student. So go to it and double click setup.exe. So it will open something like this, and now select I agree and go to next. Press next again. For me, I have already installed it. So it will show estimated time to be very less. And once it is completed 100%, press exit. And finally, ansys is installed. Search workbench 18.2. For you, it will be 19.1 and you can start ansys.